Case study, as a research method, falls into the much broader set of the so-called qualitative methodologies. So, in order to better understand what case studies are, we should first ask ourselves a preliminary question. What is qualitative research? According to Anthony W. Yeath, qualitative researchers attempt to describe and interpret some human phenomenon, often in the words of selected individuals, the informants. These researchers try to be clear about their biases, presuppositions, and interpretations so that others can decide what they think about it all. Qualitative research is therefore any type of research that produces findings not arrived at by statistical procedures or other means of quantification. Qualitative research leverages on different sources of data, such as observations, documents, films, and even quantitative data. Qualitative research was developed as a reaction to the deductive, quantitative, and rational philosophy that had overrun all sciences, even philosophy itself. It was developed starting from the realization that the lived world of humanity required a different research approach than that used for the natural world. As a consequence, the qualitative approach differs significantly from quantitative research. What are the main differences between quantitative and qualitative research, then? In quantitative research, the data collection process involves extensive data translated into numbers, an activity called quantification, analyzed through a mathematical and statistical process of interpretation. On the other hand, the data collection process in qualitative research requires intensive data on human phenomena, collected from multiple sources of evidence, and analyzed in a non-statistical manner. If we were to briefly summarize what's the paramount goal for quantitative versus qualitative research, we could dare say that quantitative research is meant to test existing theory, while qualitative research aims at generating or building new theory. Considering how these two apparently dichotomous methods relate with theory suggests that they could be employed complementarily. Theory could be first generated through a qualitative method to be later tested through a quantitative one. When both qualitative and quantitative methodologies coexist in the same study, the resulting combination is called mixed methods research. As it's becoming apparent, both groups of research, qualitative and quantitative, are based on methodologies. One of the most widely adopted qualitative methodologies in social sciences research, like management, is case study. Case study gathers data mainly based on human words and behavioral observations, as well as additional archival documents to triangulate such information. The researcher gets into the field and gathers observation, analyzing them through non-mathematical and non-statistical methods. Software is often not used for the data analysis process, although in some cases, tools for text analysis may be required. The research questions are normally open-ended and aim at analyzing complex phenomena. Case study research differs from other qualitative research methods, like qualitative surveys or collaborative or action research methods, in terms of several aspects, such as, first, the number of organizations studied, that can span from 1 to 100 or even more, differentiating case studies from in-depth studies and qualitative surveys. A case study typically includes 1 to 10 different entities analyzed, depending on whether the case is single or multiple. Second, the researcher's position towards the subject studied, whether it involves participating in the changing events or mere observation. Case studies, contrary to action research, imply an observing role of the researcher without direct intervention, which may modify the setting investigated. Third, the main source of data and information, such as interviews, documents, and the site or surrounding environment. Case study main source of evidence is traditionally represented by interviews. And fourth, the depth of information. Single case studies could involve 10 to 80 interviews for each case, whereas qualitative phone surveys involve one phone interview for each case. So far, we started shedding light on what it means to perform qualitative research as opposed to quantitative one, and what are the main methodologies for qualitative research. In the next lecture, we will understand what a case study is, what are the different kinds of case study, and we will get an overview of the main step a case study is built on.